The following presentation was recorded at the Buddhist Society of Victoria, Malvern East, Australia. Please visit our website at bsv.net.au.
Welcome, all friends in the Dhamma. Way of enlightenment. Usually you practice method of enlightenment. And there are many methods. Okay, different method. But way of enlightenment only way, not method. Okay? Way of enlightenment that is just go to your pure mind, become one with your pure mind. Your pure mind is nothingness or emptiness. You know, how to go to your pure mind, emptiness inside. Mind is like onion. You know onion? Got layer, many layer, okay? Your mind also got many layer. Layer that is your perception, okay? And now you would like to practice this method, you can do, okay? But when you practice, you need to let go attachment to what you practice together. Because otherwise, you cannot go to way of enlightenment. So how to let go what you attach? For me, just go to all master in Thailand. Practice every method. Until I like every method. First, I like this method, don't like this method. I like this method, don't like this method. It look like you eat this long time. You choose this you like. This you don't like, you not take it. But each method, it is like different kinds of food. This food got more carbohydrate. This food got more protein. This food got more mineral. Better you take all method. This method give you more power of concentration. This method give you more power of mindfulness. This method give you more wake up with awareness. First, I don't understand. I just only put the same. I only practice the same you practice. That is, focus your breathing only. After I got stuck, I just go to see other master and practice different method, and then I let go my concept, attached to concept of my method. But now, anybody just come practice first time today? Oh, so that is you, all of you got many, many knowledge, or got many concept. Okay, I found that if I teaching those only just start today, really quickly. Okay, no concept. Because why? You got more concept. Your onion, really big onion, big head. Okay. So more you try to this technique. I give you many techniques until your mind open, can accept all technique. Okay? That's why I try to bring you this way. If you attach to your method, you not listen to me, you just practice and don't listen to me. And then I tell you, just feel your breathing. No, I just focus breathing. I tell you awareness and say, no, I just focus breathing. You just attach the way you practice. Then you got stuck, okay? Because when you know actually mind is like onion, this is explained by Zen, okay? Mind is onion, okay? When you take the layer of onion, take out, until all layer you take out, what you found? Emptiness. Okay? But now you try, and you got many concepts, more layer. But now just become one with the nature. See the sky. Now can you see the sky? Sky here, sky in Thailand the same. Sky here in BSB, sky at home the same sky. No different. Okay? Same sky. No different. All layers disappear. You feel very light from inside. Very light. Okay? Okay? Sky here and now, yesterday and today and tomorrow the same. Can you see sky? And what happened? How your mind work when you see sky? When no different, then you got freedom of mind. Okay? You got freedom of mind. You get there already. Okay? And now there is a great master in Thailand, enlightened with sky meditation. How, you know? He just tell you before you close your eye, can you just reflect sky and then become one with the sky and don't focus anything. Because now your mind go to sky, become big eye. Don't have to focus, but you can see the whole body and mind and heart and deep in your mind and heart. When your eye become big as sky, your mind become awareness and see. Consciousness become sensing. Okay? Now, just see the sky again. When you see sky, you can see yourself, how you sit, how you look at the sky. Can you see yourself from consciousness, sensing, consciousness, sensing, wake up. And when you see the sky, can you see calmness? Can you sense calmness? When you see the sky, what do you see more? Can you sense calmness and more beautiful calmness? Because whenever your mind become with the sky, no different, no concept, okay? Can you see what happened to your mind? When you become one with the sky, no different, no concept, your mind become expanding. And see the sky, then what happened? You become one with the sky, then more sky is all over. You cannot focus. Can you see sky all over? Then your mind inside emptiness, outside is the onion layer. When you see the sky, you go already inside the onion, okay? And that inside the onion is the knower, wake up. And there, you get on the way to enlighten already. Doesn't matter what level, but you already get there on the way, okay? Can you see sky? No thought, no concept, okay? And how your mind is when you see sky? Emptiness. Okay? With emptiness, it become like a big mirror with good exposure, sensing himself. Now you got a big mirror with good exposure because your mind become singleness of mind, become one with the nature, become one with the sky, and all in the knowing, sitting in the knowing, sitting in the seeing of higher consciousness, okay? And you just start from higher consciousness, way of enlightenment, start from consciousness wake up or higher consciousness. Okay? You go beyond method. Before you have to practice method, how to focus, how to watch, how to be mindful, how to be aware. That is train your monkey mind. Hey, how to calm down your mind? You must watch here. But today, doesn't bother. No monkey mind. Inside is only pure mind and emptiness. Just see emptiness of all the nature. See emptiness of the sky. No monkey mind. That's right. And you just see sky, monkey mind. How can you regard this mind, God monkey mind? When you become one with the nature, no monkey mind. But when you separate from the nature, now I am, this is my, not you, not your, not take my, monkey mind. Okay? So that's why I just let you know, just your awareness wake up from inside. So if you not see sky, how to go inside? How? If you not see the sky, how? When you see sky, you got awareness from inside, wake up. That's right. So now no sky in this room, a lot of thought, okay? A lot of concept. Just awareness of your thought or whatever concept. What happened? Before you try to stop thinking, to fight the thought with thought, today you just aware, whenever you got thought, aware your thought. You got thought, aware your thought, to initiate the emptiness inside to wake up. Accept how to aware of thought. Accept. I am five aggregate. You are five aggregate. Thought is one of five aggregate or not? If you don't have thought, maybe you are a hungry goat, no thought. You got five aggregate, you have thought, okay? Just accept what you have, but not involved. Accept. When you accept, you not fight with thought. Then fight will not try to fight you. If you fight with thought try to fight you, okay? Just accept, or just make agreement, okay? We are good friends, okay? If you think, I know. If you think, I know. If you think, I know. We are good friends. You help me to wake up. If you think, I know. If you think, I got mindfulness, no, I am thinking. I got mindfulness, no, and see, I am thinking. We are good friends. You are very good friends to help me wake up. If I have no thought, I fall asleep. Okay? Okay? Just awareness from inside. Awareness from inside. The onion is a thought. All layers are thought. But inside the onion is emptiness or pureness. Okay? Just stay inside. I just tell you, stay in between. And not disturb with thought. Just, hey, you are my friend. Okay? You come, I know. You come more many friends come, I know. You got more thought, I know. Thought more, I know. What happened? When you got more thought, you know. More thought, you know. It become less thought. Less thought, I know. Less thought, my mind know. No, I'm not involved. Not fight with you. No thought, less thought again, I know. Less thought, I know. Less thought, I know. Until less thought, you know. It become no thought. No thought, I know. No thought, I know. It become calmness. Calmness, I know. Calmness, I know. It become more calmness. More calmness, I know. More calmness, I know. It become more calmness. Calmness, I know. More calmness, I know. Beautiful calmness, I know. It become all emptiness. The emptiness inside, wake up. Okay? This is I got from Zen, okay? Mahayana, how to approach into emptiness, okay? Okay? Just see emptiness, non-self, okay? And when you can see this emptiness, mind, where is your mind? Can you catch, this is your mind, this is your mind? You catch this is your mind because you got concept. Okay? But actually, the pure mind, no concept. Okay? Pure mind, no concept. Pure mind is knowing. You got thought, you know. Know is pure mind. Thought is conditioning mind, monkey mind. Okay? You got thought, you know. You got thought, you know. More thought, you know. Less thought, you know. Less thought, you know. Then no thought. No thought, you know. No thought because sometimes no thought, you say no thought, maybe ignorant, we call. No thought, and maybe sleepy. No thought, maybe ignorant. How to turn over the darkness of no thought to be the light of wisdom. You know no thought. You know no thought. The darkness gone. No thought. It doesn't mean it wake up already. No thought is still got dark inside. It got dark with ignorance. Can you know no thought? No thought. No thought. But it's still dark. You know no thought. No thought. It become understanding. Okay. Become clear knowing. Okay. Become blindness. Okay. So that's why today I just tell you the technique how to stay in between, in emptiness in between. I tell you the technique before you can realize thought, less thought, less thought, less thought, no thought. You must be able to realize chanting first. Na mo, na mo, na mo. Instead of thought, can you think about na mo? And can you realize your thought about na mo? Na mo. And who is the knower? Who is the thinker? You knower. And what you thinking is the object of knowing. Okay? Na mo, na mo. Can you see there are object and there are the one who know what you chanting? Can you just know you are chanting Namo. No clearly, no rhythm. Na is short pronunciation. Mo is long. Na, mo, na, mo, na, mo, na, mo, na, mo, na, mo. And quietly do by yourself and stay in between and cross your eye. Na, mo. You feel more wake up? Emptiness wake up? It's expansion. Expansion and got absorption. Expansion and absorption into more calmness, more emptiness. Na mo, na mo, na mo. Can you know the rhythm? Awareness more, awareness more. Don't focus na mo, don't watch na mo. Awareness and see. See by awareness. Awareness. Awareness now you chanting na. Awareness now you chanting mo. Awareness now na is short, mo is long. And awareness now na disappear. And now mo arising. Mo disappear, na arising. Na disappear, mo arising. Seeing by awareness. All layers gone, all concept gone, and the original mind emptiness wake up from inside, beautifully, expansion, and become consciousness. Consciousness, or we call higher consciousness. Sensing you are sitting, sensing you are doing, sensing you are breathing. Now, open your eye. Can you sense bodily action from emptiness? Okay, sensing without thought. Can you sense without thought? your movement, your smile. Now take picture again. One, now you got concept a lot. Two, you let go all concept. You get there already. Namo, namo, namo. Then it become sensing your smile. It's really simple, but it's because it's very simple, it's difficult, okay? Simple, when you try to do, you got concept. When you take picture, one, two, you get there already. Okay? Because when you try to do, you got a lot of self, okay? A lot of expectation to find. But when you just take picture, one, two, you smile, you get there already, okay? Now, just can you, now we call this is selfie. Can you not selfie your face? Can you selfie your mind? You got a camera inside. Can you selfie your mind? You can. Because your mind now in this social world know about selfie. When you selfie your face, your mind smile also, okay? Now, can you selfie your mind? Selfie your mind. Can you selfie your mental quality inside? Selfie. You can selfie more and more. And if you smile to your mind, your face smile a bit to your son. Your son is your mind, okay? Your son now very sleepy because you work too much, okay? Very sleepy and very tired because you work too much. You just smile to him with your face. And then just smile with good smile, selfie. It become big face, wake up. Or emptiness inside, expansion. That is your original face. So nice. Your face inside, always young. This face getting old, but inside face, very always young. Okay? Now smile in your mind. And selfie your smile inside. It always young because it originally emptiness and pureness. So now, again, open eye, take picture. Then it look like you got selfie your face. When I count two, you selfie your face, now no camera. Selfie your face to your mind inside. Together, can you? Smile with your face. Smile to camera, but smile to yourself. When you smile to your lover, but you forget your lover inside. Your lover outside, sometimes good, sometimes bad, but your lover inside always good. Can you smile to your lover inside? I love you, my son, I love you. My spirit, I love you. And cross your eyes, smile to your spirit and soul inside. With loving kindness. You never give loving kindness to your mind. You always want, okay, do good by help people, giving loving kindness to people, but never help your mind, never give loving kindness to your mind, okay? Now, giving loving kindness to your mind with smile. Smile as with as you smile to your lover. This is your true lover. Then it become emptiness, okay? Smile to your mind. Your mind only needs mind. Your body needs food, but your mind needs mind. Okay? Smile, you get there already. Emptiness. And more emptiness. If you just smile near to your mind, not far from your mind, near to your mind, and more into your mind. You got many concepts? Smile into your mind, then all concepts go away. It is only littering inside concept. Smile inside. All littering go away. You wake up with emptiness, more emptiness. If you smile to your mind, or the Buddha in Theravada, we use the word, can you just keep gladness in your mind? This is what the Buddha words, okay? When you got gladness in your mind, that is you go to the way of enlightenment. Because you can see mental state of dispassion and release, and more dispassion and more release, more release, more release, and more letting go, and more calm, and more freedom of my inside, and more, then it become pure and empty, or pureness and emptiness, okay? Good, only gladness. Gladness in your mind. Whatever method, doesn't matter. But if you have gladness, you get there already. Gladness in your mind. You got big eye, big face. It look like it become big eye seeing this person. It become big eye seeing this person. And it can see the whole sitting posture. And it can see the whole outside, inside, see how you're doing, how you're feeling. And now, even you get there, but you got a lot of perception and conceptual thought. Just seeing thought, if you got thought coming, just see thought. It's still got a bit thought. Smile and seeing thought, a bit thought. And even a bit thought you can see, then it become turned over, free from thought. Just thank you thought to help you wake up. Because in emptiness, what is the object of knowing in emptiness, you know? Thought. Okay? Usually, what is your object of meditation when you practice? Reading. Okay? Because now you go inside your mind, and inside your mind, what is object? We call mind activity. My activity as thought, or my activity as desire, whatever. Can you see behavior of mind inside? That is your object of knowing, and you stay knowing, 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 knowing. Sometimes you don't try to make judgment. This is thought, this is anger, this is desire. It's only feeling like heavy or burden. Or light, if more thought, it become disturbed, heavy, only disturbed, heavy enough. And then you just realize without concept. Okay, don't have to try to think or to try to watch, because you cannot watch inside, okay, because it no concept, okay? You just aware it got sustained, we call sustained. Even thought, even desire, or whatever, or less thought, or more thought, we call suchness. Suchness. Can you realize suchness in your mind? awareness of suchness in your mind? Or sensing suchness in your mind? Sensing. When you free from thought or conditioning inside, then you got self-realization of the moment. The present moment is only breathing in and out from there. Okay? When you can let go thought, what you can realize with self-awareness, the present moment? You do nothing, only sit and relax and breathing. Okay? Then you just awareness of the present moment, breathing in from emptiness. Breathing out from emptiness. And you can see clearly, breathing in slowly, with sensing. Before you have to focus. Now you get home, you only sensing. Can you send your breathing in every moment to the pause inside? Can you send from your mind inside? The breathing out from the pause. When you can send the breathing, you can send your mind, the knower. Can you send all together, the object and the knower? Object is your breathing, the knower is your pure mind or knowing. Knower is knowing. Knowing clearly from emptiness, knowing clearly you're breathing in, but together, clearly knowing your mind itself, can you? So, the Grand Master in Thailand just used two words, knowing clearly, and come back clearly knowing your mind together. Knowing clearly, you're breathing, and clearly knowing your mind, or knowing clearly your mind, the knower, your mind, clear knower, or pureness, okay? So you got knowing both, no outside, no inside. Outside is the breathing, inside is your mind. Can you know both? Knowing clearly knowing parallel together. Knowing clearly, knowing every moment. You stay in between. You got intuition awareness. Wake up with wisdom. Knowing clearly you're breathing, but together clearly knowing the knower. The knower before away move. Your breathing move in, you try to focus the breathing and over move along the breathing, that not good, okay? But now, you knowing clearly the breathing move, but clearly knowing the knowing is not move, okay? Knowing clearly, knowing. In Thai language, we use the word, Lu chat, แล้วก็ให้มาชัดที่รู้รู้ชัดชัดรู้ two words in Thai language. This is advanced meditation. รู้ชัดชัดรู้รู้ชัดชัดรู้รู้ชัดชัดรู้รู้ชัดชัดรู้รู้ is knowing. Chat is clearly. Okay. First, now open your eye. When you look at me, watch me, you knowing clearly. Your mind go to me. But when you clearly knowing,your mind go to the knower, go back. We call in Thailand, Thai language, when you got Lu Chat, your mind sending out. When you got Chat Lu, your mind come back. Lu Chat, Chat Lu, Lu Chat, Chat Lu. Knowing clearly, but come back clearly knowing really quickly. Knowing clearly knowing. Now, you always focus only knowing clearly. You don't have clearly knowing your mind itself.You only got knowing clearly, you might stay here. Then you got disturbed. Still, but inside, very, very burdened. Okay? Still inside, not clear and not soft. When you already come to daily life, because you got stay still and focus too much, and it very, very thick, okay? Very, very gross. You can rely yourself away, lose temper with anger very easily because you very good focus. When people speak bad to you focus and cringing, okay? Because you got only knowing clearly but not have clearly knowing your mind. You knowing clearly, people speak bad, you very good focus the breathing. Then you already there focus the voice. Then you lose temper. You lose temper and you lose clearly knowing. Okay? So now this is wrong concentration. Before I very good focus, 2 hours, 3 hours, I keep my mind still here, focus here only. You know, 6, 7 years, 8 years, I still very angry the same. Same. And then I just observe why. I can still my mind on the breathing for 10, 15 years, but I still disturb. Because I'm very good focusing. When people speak a little gossip about me, why? Because you are very good concentration on your breathing, and you lose clearly knowing the mind who was. Okay? Now, I just knowing clearly, clearly knowing. Then I stay in between. See. Now when you see, when I see in front, I can see people beside you also. But if I focus you, I cannot see anybody. I focus you. This is look. But I just correct myself. I look at my breathing, just go back a bit, just watch. Watch from inside. What from inside, my temper calm down. In daily life, my temper calm down. My anger calm down because I watch from inside. But still got a bit anger. When I watch and see myself, my anger, riding horse, come to me. I see myself, go away. It's not me. I'm not angry anymore. Not me. Go away. Okay. Again, anger come, riding horse. But I have awareness. Anger cannot overcome my mind. Okay? So you must come to your mind, watch, and see yourself. Then you can free yourself from all distraction, all stress, all anger. Okay? Now I am a laughing monk, you know? Always laughing. Okay? My heart so joyful, okay? Okay? Animal anger, but more laughing. Feel good. Okay? Really happy, okay? Teaching whole day, 2 day, 3 day, always happy also, okay? No tired, okay? So I teaching from my spirit and from my spiritual. What I say from my spiritual. Okay, from my spiritual. Okay? My heart joy, always joyful. Then it got my characteristic. Like maybe what is in you know characteristic of those monks in the Buddha time also different. Okay? Different. Sariputta, you know. Sariputta. What characteristic of Sariputta? Sariputta just walk like a monkey. Just jump. Always jump. Sariputta. Jump. Always jumping. Sariputta. Something like that. Okay? So before I just try to control myself. Still and calm. But now I am myself. Okay? Doesn't matter. Okay? I want to smile, I smile. I want to laugh, I laugh. Okay, this is mine. Okay? Because even Sariputta, sometimes like a monkey. Okay? Jump. Okay? Something like that. Enlightenment is not on your body. Enlightenment is inside. Okay? If you try to keep inside and fight inside, then you feel not nice, not natural. Then it obstructs. Okay? Okay? So now, just keep your heart good. And don't let people see whoever you are. Enough. Okay? Don't have to know what my level is. No, don't have to know. Just keep your heart good. Okay? I'm just normal people, normal person. Okay? Enough. Just keep your heart good. Okay? So, to develop very good mindfulness and awareness. When you got sad, don't let people know you got sad. Now you got sad, you talk a lot. Oh, I call in my family with my wife, with my husband. You talk, you tell people a lot. Then you lose mindfulness. If you got sadness, don't let people know you got sadness. My sadness, I correct myself, okay? I show myself, okay? Then you got more power of mind, okay? Because you saw yourself, okay? Okay, now Buddha again. Buddha are now long chanting. Buddha, Dhammo, Sangho. Can you know every moment and the pause in the between? Buddha, Dhammo, Sangho, Sangho, aware. You cannot watch. Breathing outside object, you can watch. Mind just aware. Okay? And if in your heart, just sensing. In your heart, you cannot watch, but you can aware and notice. But deeply, just sensing. So they are step by step. In the beginning, you look and watch. Okay? Look and watch your breathing. But when you close your eye, you watch only. Because when you close your eye, you don't have to use your eye to look, but your mind can watch. But if you open eye, you look object outside, your eye look, then you have to connect, look, and watch, okay? But when you watch your breathing, you don't have to use your eye, then you just watch from your mind. But watch and aware of the one who watch, you got seeing, okay? Okay, now, watch and aware of the one who watch. That means, can you watch your breathing awareness and see the calmness or more or less together or even a bit thought? Can you get awareness and see how your mind work together? Now, watch your breathing and see clearly. See clearly your breathing and clearly seeing your mind together. See clearly your breathing and clearly seeing your mind. Clearly seeing the one who was. Now do it now. Close your eye. Watch and awareness of the one who was. Seeing clearly. Seeing clearly what you was. And seeing clearly the one who was. Or two words. Seeing clearly your breathing. Clearly seeing your mind. Seeing clearly your breathing in, clearly seeing your mind, who was, okay? Clearly. Seeing clearly, seeing clearly your breathing, clearly seeing the one who know and see your breathing, clearly seeing the one who know and see your breathing together. Then all layers of onion, all conceptual thought go away, all layers of thought go away by itself. And gladness in your mind, in the knower with gladness together. It become expanding with gladness. And smile to your mind, or selfie your mind. Your mind more wake up. Smile only, then you got seeing clearly and more clearly. All letting go. All in your mind become released and letting go. You got thought, smile to your thought. Then you got seeing thought clearly and not fight with thought. More or less thought, smile to your more or less thought. Then thought going away by themselves. More smile to your mind, you don't have to focus the breathing, but you got awareness from inside automatically how you are breathing in with natural awareness, how you're breathing out with clear awareness. More awareness now in your mind. Before you start with concentration, but when you get there in your mind, you just develop more awareness and less concentration. More awareness, you can wake up and see inside the mental state. More awareness inside, you can see even your mind, the knower, calm and empty. But still got a bit thought. So now just know your thought, see your thought. Don't focus thought. See your thought by awareness, a bit thought, even a bit thought. Why awareness? Or smile. Smile, you got awareness. When you got thought, you smile more and more, then you can see thought going away. Okay? The Buddha used the word gladness in your mind. But now you don't have gladness in your mind, then I let you keep you smile first. Smile until your mind become gladness by nature. Smile more and more, then it become gladness by nature. Now you got wake up with seeing clearly the whole breathing. Okay? Whole breathing, and you got seeing near to your mind. That is, even thought you can see near or inside your mind. But anyhow, you got breathing or not? When you become awareness in your mind, breathing become short, short and shorter. And breathing from rupa nimitta, transform to nama nimitta in your mind. From red body nimitta, transform to nama nimitta in your mind. Before you have to focus the breath in front of your nose. But now it's transformed to be the breathing nama object in your mind. You just aware inside and it become only small breathing inside. Keep awareness of small breathing or short breathing inside more and more with smile. Then it becomes very soft, subtle breathing. Going deeply, even breathing short, but it not mean that it's very shallow. Breathing short, but it's deep. It's deep into your spirit and soul, you know? You can feel in your mind, so deep breathing, even it's short. Now breathing transform to whole breathing into your spirit and soul, okay? Clearly knowing, before you have to focus to develop knowing clearly. Now turn inwards, clearly knowing, full awareness inside, with nice, soft, and subtle breathing everywhere into your spirit and soul, not only into your body. And now just stay there. Stay there with awareness of your breathing into your spirit and soul. It will clear all dirtiness in your spirit and soul. And stay there, seeing the breathing into your spirit and soul, and seeing the knower become clear and clean, cleaner and clearer, and pureness. And trust in the Buddha, gladness with trust in the Buddha. Then, from now, you learn from the Buddha. If you got trust in the Buddha will bring you going inside more and more with the power of Buddha, Dhamma, Sangha. Trust in the Buddha. See what you see, because now you go inside deeply with the power of Buddha, Dhamma, Sangha. See what you see and just learn. Now learn inside your meditation. Learning. Learning inside will wake up the Buddha nature with exploring more and more inside, even you got emptiness, but with the Buddha, power of Buddha, Dhamma, Sangha, you wake up and explore a bit thought or a bit attachment in emptiness, or whatever, a bit in emptiness. Just trust in the Buddha. And again, clearly knowing at the knowing, knowing at the knowing, all what you know is all illusion. Just come back clearly knowing the knowing itself, that is the way. And the light of wisdom by the Buddha come to your mind. When you come back to clearly knowing, you always try to follow the object. All object inside is not real, it's illusion. The real is the knowing. That's why I emphasize, when you know something clearly, you must come back clearly knowing the mind itself. Clearly knowing the knower, clearly knowing the knower. Mind is the knower. The way to enlightenment, you just stay with the knower, become with the knower. The knower is nothingness. The knower, because it's nothingness, it becomes pureness. And now, you don't have to do anything. Just let go. Desire, let go, expectation, let go. It will become absorbed by itself. It absorbs into emptiness inside. You cannot try to be absorbed, okay? Just let go. Just know what you know clearly, knowing clearly, knowing near to your mind, in your mind, clearly knowing. It wake up more and more. With clearly knowing, you got I inside, big I, seeing all emptiness, but you're not enlightened yet. Even you see all emptiness, sometime got a bit thought coming, just see thought coming, don't fight with thought, just see with accept, understanding that you got thought, and then it let go by itself. Just stay at home, knowing whatever happening, knowing what you know, seeing what you see. That is knowing and not involved, knowing and not involved. It more open up to unbounded emptiness. It looks like big space and clearness there. And in emptiness, just be mindful, awareness. Even you are in emptiness, you also got breathing, but don't forget breathing. Just awareness in emptiness. All emptiness, but what not emptiness is now you still alive, you got breathing, you just need to be aware of your soft and subtle breathing in your emptiness or in your awareness. Then the way will be open for you to go on the path to enlightenment. Awareness, just aware you are breathing, that's enough. And see what you see. And what you see, just let go. Just knowing clearly knowing in your mind. With your breathing. The real thing is now you got this body, you still got breathing. Even you go deep, can you still aware of soft and subtle breathing? Then you wake up again in emptiness, if you awareness of soft and subtle breathing in emptiness. Wake up with gladness now, because you got breathing as your home. And don't have to focus breathing. Just awareness of nice breathing in your mind. Because breathing now, it's not breathing into your lung, it's breathing into your spirit and soul everywhere. When you got awareness in your mind of your breathing, in your mind that is spirit and soul there. Breathing go absorb into your mind, into your spirit and soul, as big as sky. Now you got breathing into the sky or into the spirit and soul, as big as sky. Before you just breathing very shallow into your lung, but now you breathing very deep into the spirit and soul as big as sky. Now just know you're breathing into the sky more and more every moment. Then you will see the way by yourself. Don't worry about what next, don't worry. just know your breathing, soft and soft in your spirit and soul, or in the sky. Your spirit and soul wake up as big as sky. And stay there with smile. Smile, you know everything. Or with gladness. Gladness, you know everything. Or you know even the way to enlightenment. Or you see clearly the way to enlightenment by your mind with gladness. Gladness, gladness, gladness. The way open for you if you got gladness in your mind. Smile, you got wake up with seeing. Smile deep inside your mind, to your spirit and soul all over. It become more consciousness all over. Now you already at home, the nature of mind. Just stay there at home. After long journey, you get there already. Just stay there with gladness and trust in the Buddha. And from there, you can sense this body. And this body got sensation. You can sense sensation of this body. Now you can use sensing. From the pureness, you can sense your thought. Where thought come from? Where? When you sense your thought, it become no thought. Now your sensing wake up already. Thought cannot overcome you. You can sensing. You can sense your sitting. You can sense your sensation. You can sense your thought. You can sense your feeling. You can sense your mind and mental quality deeply. All emptiness. When you sense, it become all emptiness. All is illusion. Mind is empty. Whatever you see is only illusion. See what you see, but don't forget seeing clearly the knower. Clearly seeing the knower. Knowing clearly, clearly knowing. Knowing clearly, clearly knowing. Come back to the knower, not lost. And there you become one with the Buddha nature and trust again in the Buddha. Trust in your practice with mind. From there, the emptiness mind, the pureness mind, you can rely with self-awareness of the five aggregates of this body. you can realize body aggregates is sitting. Sensation aggregate is calm down. Thought aggregate is calm down. Perception aggregate is calm down. But consciousness aggregate, wake up with seeing clearly all everything. Seeing clearly body aggregate and seeing clearly the calmness of all monkey mind, the perception, sensation and thought. Now just more wake up at the seeing clearly. Seeing clearly, this is who is sitting. It's just getting to aging, sickness, and one day must die. Just contemplate the body with the pureness, with seeing clearly. And when you see clearly the body, you can see clearly your monkey mind. Monkey mind go far away because you got seeing wake up. Before you not have seeing wake up, monkey mind come and make you got thought, perception, and sensation. But now you become pure mind. Pure mind is pure consciousness. And the monkey mind fading away, far away. And pure consciousness wake up. It looks like you got a brightness wake up from inside all over your body more and more. And trust in the Buddha again. Then your consciousness become more and more expanding, become one with the Buddha nature. Now you stay in between because you see three dimensions, see the body aggregate, see monkey mind, see yourself the consciousness aggregate. You stay in between. Just stay in between with knowing clearly, seeing clearly and not involved. It only, this body only five aggregate. You cannot regard anything as you or belong to you, nothingness. When you realize this truth, you wake up again with intuition or wisdom. Wisdom might wake up. As the Buddha said before, he never found wisdom mind. He's still traveling. The Buddha said in the chanting, Pathe Kalatara Sutta. When he found the wisdom mind of pure consciousness, now no more. No more traveling. Okay? And all desire, attachment, release, more release, because no traveling anymore. He got wisdom mind, clear knowing and clear seeing. All release. All the lover who steal your heart for a long, long time, now going away. Now your heart got freedom. Freedom from the 10 chains who hanging you with attachment. And there you realize the freedom of mind, or the Buddha nature and stay there with absorption. It become absorbed by itself, become one with the nature all around, all over. Emptiness mind is as big as the nature all over. Now your empty mind wake up, and you got the freedom of mind. And before we finish this session, just learn how you realize inside. Review. Learn, you got more exploring, more investigation. This is the factor of enlightenment, one of the seven factors of enlightenment. Before you finish meditation, you just leave your meditation quickly. Now you have to learn. Before you leave your meditation, learn. Then you got one of the seven factors of enlightenment wake up. That is mindfulness, fulfillment, and investigation into the mind fulfillment. Now it become investigation more and more into the nature of mind, or exploring into the nature of mind, all very pure inside. But in the pureness, you got some dirtiness. Never mind. Now you can see all together. Then you know what is good, what is not good. Review more and more. You learn by your experience now, not from me. I just bring you to how to learn by your experience. Your experience, then you got wisdom. All will become your experience. Review now. If you not review, you just leave meditation. It's my experience teaching you. But now you review, you got your own experience. Review what you feel, the calmness, how you feel, the calmness, how you feel, wake up, how you feel, mindfulness. Review. It become absorb. Absorption of mind into your mind, and all dirtiness gone, okay? It repress all dirtiness in your mind. Repress with knowledge from your learning and review. When you are over understanding, just share it with smiling to everybody here and now. In your country, Australia, and all over the world, with smiling. When you share merit to all people, all beings, then bring back to yourself by smile to yourself. All merit come back to yourself for your good health and for your happiness, real happiness, success, and Dhamma are in this very life. And now just slowly moving and relax your body and breathing deeply, naturally, and slowly opening your eyes. And now we finish this session. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. Oh, 2-hour session. Ho, 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 ho.